It's AumSum time!
How does a snake move?
Simple. It moves like the famous AumSum.
Oh, AumSum.
To buy AumSum merchandise, visit AumSum.com.
Snakes display up to four different types of movements. Firstly, serpentine locomotion. In this type of movement, the snake moves in the form of a sinusoidal wave. Secondly, concertina or accordion locomotion. In this type of movement, the body of the snake contracts and expands successively like an accordion or a spring. Thirdly, lateral displacement or sidewinding locomotion. In this type of movement, the snake moves laterally by forming vertical waves. In this way, it minimizes contact with the surface. This type of movement is typical of snake species found in desert areas. Fourthly, rectilinear locomotion. In this type of movement, the snake crawls in a straight line with its body stretched. This type of movement is commonly found among larger snakes as it allows them to access narrow burrows of their potential prey. What if all snakes disappeared?
Then I will become a snake and scare everybody.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, snakes primarily snack on mice or rats. With all snakes gone, mice or rats will have a gala time. Musophobia, as in fear of mice or rats, might set in. Secondly, venom from snakes plays a very important role in the development of medicines. They've been used in the treatment of heart attacks as well as blood disorders. With no more snakes, medical research might suffer a lot. Thirdly, animals like mongoose, eagles, and hawks will really miss snakes. This is because they are known to kill and eat them. Fourthly, many iconic Hollywood films like Anaconda, Harry Potter series, etc. have snakes playing important roles. With no snakes, Hollywood scriptwriters might face tough times. Lastly, people with ophidiophobia, as in fear of snakes, will have nothing to worry about anymore. Why do snakes have forked tongue?
Just for fashion.
No. Even though snakes have noses, they smell odors of their prey, mate, or surroundings with the help of their tongue and vomeronasal organ. Each time a snake flicks its tongue in air, it collects odor particles. Then, when the tongue is brought back, the particles are transferred to the vomeronasal organ. This organ detects the odors and sends signals to the brain, helping the snake smell.
Wow, that's interesting.
Now, we know that when we see with our two separate eyes, our brain combines the two different perspectives and makes a detailed image of our surrounding. Similarly, because the tongue of a snake is forked, it collects odor particles from two different locations, helping the snake understand in which direction the odor is coming from, and thus making it easier to locate the prey.
Why do snakes shed their skin?
Wait, I'll explain. When a snake grows, its outer skin layer called epidermis does not grow or get bigger with it. Hence, the snake sheds its epidermis periodically to allow further growth of its body. In addition to this, shedding also helps remove parasites present on the epidermis.
So does the snake buy a new skin?
No. First, listen. Before shedding, the snake grows a new epidermis beneath the old one and secretes a fluid between the old and new epidermis. This fluid helps separate the old epidermis from the new one. Once this is done, the process of shedding begins. To remove the old epidermis, the snake rubs its head against any hard surface, creating a tear either near mouth or near nose area. Then, it drags and wriggles its body against any hard surface and slowly slithers out of the old epidermis. Snake versus mongoose. Who wins? I, me, and myself. Alright, a snake, especially a cobra, is a tasty meal for the mongoose. So, it fights to kill, while the cobra fights to defend itself. When the cobra strikes, the mongoose's lightning speed helps it dodge the strikes, causing the cobra to miss repeatedly. But what if the cobra succeeds in striking? Toxins in the snake's venom attach to the acetylcholine receptors, blocking communication between nerves and muscles, ultimately causing death. However, in mongoose, these receptors are mutated or shaped differently. The toxin cannot attach to the receptors, making venom ineffective. Eventually, when the cobra gets exhausted, the mongoose snaps with its sharp teeth, killing the cobra and winning the battle. Mostly, between the cobra and mongoose, mongoose wins. However, if the snake is a viper or boa constrictor, then the mongoose can be killed. How do animals hibernate? Usually during winter. It is quite cold and the food is scarce. Hence, in order to survive during winter, many animals snuggle up in burrows, caves, tree trunks, etc., and remain inactive as if they are in a deep sleep. This state of inactivity is called hibernation, and the animals which hibernate, such as bears, bats, groundhogs, ground squirrels, etc., are called hibernators. Now, during hibernation, many changes take place in their bodies. For example, their heartbeat and breathing rate slow down. Their body temperature goes way down. Also, many animals don't even eat or drink. Instead, they eat a lot before hibernating and store the food in their bodies in the form of fat. Then, while hibernating, the hibernators use the stored fat to keep themselves alive in the winter. Depending on the species, some of them might not even urinate or defecate for days or weeks. Then, when winter is over and the climate is favorable, the hibernators wake up and perform their regular activities.
Wake up! Wake up, dude! You're dreaming! Humans dream during their rapid eye movement stage of sleep, or REM sleep. In a research, the brain activity pattern of a rat running for some cheese and the one during its REM sleep was found to be similar. Moreover, a singing bird's brain activity while singing and while in its REM sleep also showed similarity, indicating that perhaps animals dream of their daily activities.
Do animals live longer than humans?
No, only I have the potion of eternal life.
All right. Now listen. When we are young, our cells divide rapidly to replace the old dying cells. They even fight against diseases and help us remain healthy. However, as we begin to age, the cells cannot efficiently divide and fight against diseases. Thus, eventually our lifespan begins to come to an end. Now, it is believed that animals live longer because of the environments they live in. For example, animals that live in cold oceans have slow metabolic rates. According to a study, slow metabolic rate slows down the aging process, thus making those animals live longer. For example, Greenland sharks, which are found in cold Arctic oceans, can live up to 400 years. In addition to this, it is observed that the size of an animal also plays a role in determining its lifespan. Smaller the animal, more are the number of predators. Hence, the risk of dying early is high. Thus, animals like mice have a lifespan of about 1 to 2 years as compared to elephants, whose lifespan is about 60 years. However, animals like bats and some other birds are an exception to this size rule. Even though they are small, they don't die early and live a longer life because they have evolved strong defense mechanisms. Moreover, it is also observed that some species which breathe fewer times per minute seem to live longer. For example, a tortoise, which takes about 4 to 5 breaths per minute, lives for more than 100 years, while a dog, which takes about 24 breaths per minute, lives for approximately 10 to 20 years. Also, according to a study, very small species of animals, like flies and worms, lack the cells which divide and replace the old ones. Hence, they don't live a long life. Can animals predict natural disasters?
I don't know, dude.
Alright, I'll explain. It is believed that animals can hear certain sounds or detect certain changes prior to disasters and thus perceive the upcoming danger.
But how, dude?
The initial activities which lead to earthquakes, tsunamis, etc. create infrasounds which arrive faster than the main shockwave. These sounds are inaudible to humans, but animals like flamingos, elephants, rhinoceros, etc. can hear them. Thus, they perceive the coming danger and probably escape. It is also said that the Earth's magnetic field slightly deflects before an earthquake. It is suspected that dogs detect this deflection and thus predict the arriving disaster. Some researchers also think that birds can foresee the approaching storm or tornado because they detect changes in atmospheric pressure, wind speeds, temperature, etc. Hence, they fly away to a safer place.